What is a mixed bus? What is a subgroup? How to send channels to a bus? What does pre-EQ, post-EQ, pre-fader, post-fader mean? And how to tap the signal coming out of the bus?
First of all, click on Setup and then go to the right to the configuration page. And right here you have configuration presets for the buses. So the first number is how many of them is pre-fader, the second number is how many of them is a subgroup, and the third number is how many of them is post-fader. You can use these if you want, I'd never really used them. And when you scroll through them, you see each bus is what. Okay, but these are just limited to pre-fader, post-fader, and a subgroup. If you want to have anything else, you're gonna go to the bus, click on bus, select the bus, then go to the home page, scroll to the right to the configuration page, and right here you have these options.
Before I get into all the different configurations, what is a bus? You can think of a bus as a vehicle, like a real life school bus, for example, that takes kids from different places all together to one destination. Okay, so a bus is something that you send different channels to. The different channels are coming from different places. They all go together to a same destination.
I'm gonna start with the subgroup configuration because this is the easiest to understand. There's also these. And these are different from these, and we'll talk about all of them. But let's start with the subgroup first. So I'm gonna select subgroup, assign, then confirm. And a subgroup behaves the exact same way as the main bus, okay? The main left and right. So when you work on a channel, right, you do compression, EQ, and then you raise the fader. You send all of the sound from that channel to the main bus, right?
A subgroup is exactly that. So in case you have many channels that you want to pre-mix, or in other words, like drums, for example, you have many drum microphones and you want to apply some EQ or compression to all of them together before you send them to the main left, right, you're gonna use a subgroup. And here's how to send channels to a subgroup.
You're gonna select the bus or the subgroup in this case, and then click on the flip fader button. And then you're gonna unmute the channels that you want to be sent to that bus. And then turn off this button again. This is very important, okay? Always remember to turn it off when you're done. Now, this bus isn't going anywhere, or it's going from the output number one on the back of the console, but we're using it in this case as a group to send to the main left right. So we're gonna select it and hit main stereo. So now this is going to the main left right. Cool. But the channels that we used on this are still going to the main left right. So they are going to the main left right and to the bus that is also going to the main left right. And we don't want that. So we're gonna select each one individually and turn off the main stereo button.
Unless you want to do parallel processing, then you can keep these channels on the main left right and also on the bus. And then you're gonna do the compression, for example, on the built-in compressor of the bus, okay? Not the insert, because if you use an insert, you will have phasing problems because the built-in compressor or EQ have the latency accounted for. The insert is not accounted for. So you will have all kinds of phasing problems and you'll lose all the bass. But in case you want to use an insert, you're gonna have to, first of all, remove the channels from the main left right. And you're gonna use two different subgroups and put the exact same insert on both of them and turn off one of them. Okay, so it's only active on one of the two buses, but it's the same exact delay, so you'll not have any phasing problems.
An important thing to note before I move on to the other configurations is that each two buses will be the same. So if I select bus number one and I say it's a pre-fader bus, bus number two will also be a pre-fader, okay? So bus number one, bus number two is the same. You cannot have two different configurations on two buses that are next to each other. I can have bus number three be a post-fader, that's fine. But each two buses will have the same configuration always.
Okay, let's move on to regular buses. And these are a bit different than subgroups because they don't go to the main left-right. They have their own output on the back of the console. So you'd use that for like stage wedges or in-ear monitors.
There are three ways to send channels to a bus. First one is to use the bus send section. So you're gonna select the channel and then go here and turn the encoder. And this is now sending channel number one to bus number one. If you want to send it to bus number 11, you're gonna click here, 9 to 12, and 9, 10, 11. This is the encoder, and turn it. You're sending channel number 1 to bus number 11. This is a very slow way, and it's very inefficient, and I don't like it. The other way is to select the channel, okay, and flip fader. And now, if you look on the bus's side, it says channel 1, arrow, 2, bus number 1, channel 1, 2, bus number 2. So you're going to raise the fader on the bus, and this is sending the channel to that bus. This is also a slow way. The best way to do it is to select the bus itself while you have the flip fader on and send as many channels as you want to that bus. Then select another bus and send different channels to it. This is the quickest way to do it. And then remember to turn off this because you don't want to mess up your mix. So always remember to turn off the flip fader button. If you don't remember that, you can use these the slower way. It's fine. But this is quicker, but you need to remember to turn off this button after you finish.
So now that you know how to send channels to a bus, let's talk about how to tap the signal, or in other words, at which point in that signal chain you are sending the audio to the bus. Before the EQ, after the EQ, before the fader, after the fader. And there are two different taps. There are the taps for the channels and for the output of the bus, and we'll talk about that.
These have nothing to do at all with the processing on the bus. So if you have compression or EQ on the bus itself, these right here do not affect them at all. They affect what's coming from the channel itself. So if I send this channel to bus number 1, and I have on this channel EQ and compression and gate and whatever I have there, and I go to the bus and say that the bus is taking the signal from the input or the local in, it means that on the channel the signal is getting out straight after the input, so it's not being affected by the gate or the EQ or the compression or the insert. If you have an insert, it's straight after the input going to the bus. Okay, now if I go back to that bus and say that I want it pre-EQ and confirm, that means that the signal is going through the input, going through the gate, and if you have an insert pre-EQ, it's also going through the insert and going out to the bus before it gets to the EQ. Okay? Then I'm gonna go back to the bus and say it's post-EQ. And that means that the signal is going through the input, the gate, the insert, if it's before the EQ, and the EQ, and straight after the EQ, it's going to the bus before getting into the compression. Then I'm going to go back to the bus and say that I want it pre-fader and confirm. And that means that the signal is going through the input, through the gate, through the insert, if it's pre-EQ, and through the EQ, and through the compression, and straight before getting to the fader. So the fader position of the channel doesn't affect the level that is going into the bus. However, pre-fader does not mean also that this is taken into account. So if you have an insert at the end, after the dynamics, the insert is after the fader. So if you have pre-fader on the bus, it means that the insert doesn't take effect. Okay, this is very important. I'm gonna go back to the bus and say that it's post fader. It means that everything on the channel is taking effect, including the insert, including the position of the fader. So if I send this channel to the bus at this level, okay, and then I raise or lower the fader, it will affect the level that is going into the bus. Cool?
Wow, that was a lot, and that's just half of it. So why don't you take a break and hit the like button while you're at it if you're finding this video helpful so far. And what we just talked about right now was how to tap the signal going out of the channels into the bus. But we can also tap the signal that is going out of the bus. And here's how to do it.
You're gonna click on routing and then go to the right, to the out page. And by default, buses 1 to 14 are routed to the outputs 1 to 14, which are the XLR outputs on the back of the console, as 15, 16 is just the main left and right. And also by default, all the buses are post fader, which means if I go to the bus and then go to the home page, you can do EQ, compression, or add an insert. And this means that all this takes effect, including the fader position. So if I raise or lower the fader, the level is changing. However, if I go back to the routing page and say that bus number one on output number one is pre-fader, it means that the fader position doesn't affect it anymore. The same level is going through regardless of the fader position. Now, what's different on this page compared to what's on the bus configuration page is that here we have plus M, and the M stands for mute. So how it is right now, if I press mute, the signal doesn't get muted. But if I say pre-fader plus mute, it means that if the mute is pressed, the signal is gone. Okay, so that's the difference between this page and the other. But these are the same. I'm not going to explain them again because they are the same.
Okay, so a bus is for channels, but what comes after a bus? What's the next step? A bus for buses? That's called a matrix. So click right here to learn everything you need to know about matrices on this console. And oh, if you haven't hit the like button already, come on, what are you waiting for? Okay, you can go right here.